Hey, how's it going, everyone? With watchOS 6 and the Series 5 Apple Watch now officially released, I know there's a lot of people buying an Apple Watch for the first time or maybe upgrading from an older model to the newest OS. Whatever your situation may be, I'm just going to go ahead and share with you guys my top favorite tips and tricks that I use day to day on my Apple Watch with you guys so you could also get the most out of your Apple Watch. This doesn't just simply just apply for the Series 5. As long as you're on watchOS 6, some of these features also may apply. To get started, I want to share with you guys the ability to ask Siri to find your Apple Watch. That's right, in case you lost your Apple Watch somewhere around your household, you're having a hard time finding it, you could actually ask Siri to find your Apple Watch. Siri doesn't just simply send a PIN notification to your Apple Watch, but it also utilizes the heart rate monitoring system to do a flash to make it easier to find. And in case you're not aware of this, you could also do the same thing vice versa. So, using your Apple Watch, if you hold down to bring up the control center, this icon, if you tap on it, it'll send a PIN sound to your iPhone. But if you hold it, it'll actually use flash to find your device. New for these Apple Watches, if you have your Apple Watch unmuted, if you tap the screen with two fingers, your Apple Watch will actually verbally speak out the time.
11:39 a.m.
Found a funny glitch, or you want to screenshot a certain conversation? Go ahead and enable this by quickly going into your Apple Watch settings, go into general, scroll down until you see screenshots, enable. Enabling this, as soon as you press the crown wheel on the power button, it's going to take a screenshot and send that rollover image to your camera roll on your iPhone. Performing this combo task whenever you start a workout, like something like an outdoor run, not only can you tap to skip the timer to begin working out immediately, but pressing those two combo buttons, this will also pause and resume your workout, and you could disable the screenshot if this gets annoying. If you have a Series 5 and you enjoy having the always on display enabled, but you don't like others to also be able to see the sensitive information that your complications may hold, like your calories burned, the steps you track, those kind of complications. Well, if you quickly go into your Apple Watch setting, go to display and brightness, scroll down where you see always on, tap on that, enabled, hide sensitive complications. Now, whenever always on display is enabled, those complications get grayed out. New for watchOS 6, you could actually request Siri to open up certain websites by asking it general questions. So for example, what was Napoleon's last fight? Simply scroll down, open tab, and it'll take you to the source of where Siri got that information, and you could literally browse the web right there. Do keep in mind, Apple has it so it does not open up social media platforms, but I have made a video on how you could do this, which you could click on the little right hand corner if you wish to find out more. Think the screen is too small? Wish there was a way to zoom in. By triple tapping the crown wheel, you can zoom in manually. Now, if you want to find out how to enable this, just go into your Apple Watch settings, go all the way down to accessibilities, go all the way down until you see accessibility shortcuts, and just check mark on the zoom. Now triple tapping the crown wheel, it will enable this, and you can use your fingers to navigate around the screen. When taking your heart rate, if you have an Apple Watch that supports ECG or ECK, if you place your finger on the crown, instead of measuring every 3 seconds or so, it will actually begin measuring it every second for a more quicker result. If you have a ton of applications, this honeycomb layout might be really frustrating to locate a certain application, which is why when you 3D press, you can actually do list view. Everything is alphabetical order, and it's much easier to find certain applications. Something new for watchOS 6, you can now actually have the ability to actually delete native applications. Not all native apps, but if there are certain native apps that you don't plan on using, like Cycles or Noise, just simply hold out until it starts shaking, tap delete, or on the list viewer, you can simply slide and delete it this way. You can reinstall these applications inside the App Store. Another new thing for watchOS 6, we have the calculator app. The calculator app isn't just a simple calculator, it also has some shortcuts of its very own. If you 3D press, you are given the tip function, where you can enter the total amount, tap the tip, and use the crown wheel to calculate the tip percent you want to give, as well as split it with the people you're with. Are you at work or a place where you don't want to be bombarded with a ton of notifications, but you've been purposely placed inside an annoying group chat? Fear no more. By tapping on the upper part of the screen, your watch will give you a hectic feedback and slide down to bring down your notification center. Simply slide right, tap this, and you can actually deliver these notifications quietly. And afterwards, you can reverse the process. You can also bring up the control center while using any app. It's the same, very similar process. Just hold down from the bottom instead. And then here's your control center. If you go down, tap edit, and you can rearrange it however you like. In the battery life section, you not only see the battery life percentage of the Apple Watch, but also the battery life percentage of those headphones as well. When using nightstand mode, as soon as you place your Apple Watch on the charging dock, if you tap this little small percentage on the corner, it will actually give you the exact number. Do you have a lot of watch faces and you want to reorganize them without having to delete them and redo your complication layout? You don't have to do that, as you can actually hold on the watch face like so and move it and click and drag it left to right, however way you want to organize them. Fun fact, added bonus, the application noise. The decibel reader is actually extremely accurate to a really expensive decibel reader, according to this source and many others. Chimes on Apple Watch was something new that they added for watchOS 6. If you want to go ahead and enable this, simply just go into your settings, go to accessibilities, and then scroll down where you see chimes, enable this. And now, depending on the settings, if you leave it on every hour, 30 minutes, or 15 minutes, don't recommend 15 minutes, very repetitive. But depending on where you left it, if you want to leave it to bells or birds on the hour, every hour, your Apple Watch will play sound, or if left on vibrate, will tap you on your wrist every hour. I love using this feature because I feel like I'm more aware of my time, making me more productive. So if you're trying to seek that productive lifestyle, definitely do recommend enabling this. It really does help out a lot in keeping track of time. Another thing that I recommend to enable in your settings application is the fall detection. By default, this is going to be disabled unless you're over the age of 50, I believe it is. This gets enabled by itself, but it's free, it's there to use. And there's already been multiple reports and documents of people's lives already been saved because of this feature. So since it's there, it's free to use, I really do advise for you to go ahead and enable this. So to quickly enable this, go into your settings, go all the way down to the SOS tab. Where you see fall detection, just enable this, hit confirm, and now, in case you do fall down and you're left unconscious, unresponsive, your Apple Watch will not only contact your people that you have listed for emergency contacts, but will also get emergency dispatchers to your location. So exclusive to the Series 5 is the Compass application. In this application, it not only gives you a compass reading, but down here, you actually have a level which you can actually take off and actually place on a flat surface to level whatever project or material you're trying to identify its level rating. I guess this is more like a quick hack. But not only that, if you 3D press, you can actually manually adjust the bearing as well by using the crown wheel. Do you have a certain catchphrase that your friends and family know that you always reply with? If you go on your iPhone and actually go into the Apple application for the Apple Watch, quickly go into the message tab, default replies, and go down to add reply. Enter your catchphrases or any smart reply you want it to also be included whenever you reply on a message without using dictation or scribbles. And lastly, these two I already covered in a previous video, but I'm gonna go ahead and cover it again real quick in case you missed it. But I know for a fact I can't be the only one because this happened to me multiple times. Have you ever put on your Apple Watch on first thing in the morning and you go out throughout your day, like 3 or 2 hours later, you realize, why am I not getting any notifications? Well, that's because that's when you realize your Apple Watch was locked. So to prevent this from happening, I definitely do recommend to go in your iPhone, go back on your Apple Watch app, go into the passcode section, enable unlock with iPhone. Now, as soon as you unlock your iPhone while you're wearing your Apple Watch will automatically get unlocked to prevent this event from ever happening. You may also do the exact same thing, but your Apple Watch will actually unlock your MacBook. If you don't know how to enable this, if you're on your desktop, on the left-hand corner right here, tap on the little Apple logo, go into System Preferences, Security tab, Security and Privacy, and quickly checkmark the Apple Watch that you want to enable. It's gonna ask you for your password, just simply enter it. And now, next time, whenever you tap to wake up your screen or unlock your open up your laptop, you will get a push notification letting you know that your MacBook is unlocked, and now you have quick and easy access to your MacBook. But there we have it. That was my list of my top favorite tips and tricks. I didn't really number these, but I want to say I have like 26 or 27 of them in this list. If you know the exact number or want to share some tips and tricks of your very own, feel free to comment that down below. And if you learned something new, make sure to like this video and also get subscribed, because the in-depth comparison between the Series 4 and the Series 5 is coming next. I can't wait for you guys to see that. But thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll catch you all in the next one.